And welcome back to the channel today, Libra. Today, we are going to go over your year for 2022. We're going to start off by shuffling some tarot cards. You are starting off your year with the Magician. And this is you being able to create the things that you desire. Whether that's manifesting a new job, a new project, starting a new relationship, finding balance, whatever it is in January that you start your year off with. Whatever you are trying to manifest, this is saying that you have the tools at your disposal to make that happen. Moving forward into February, you get the Page of Wands. The Page of Wands is seen as a messenger. So keep an eye out moving into February for messages. It could be phone calls, texts, emails, whatever it may be, that some sort of news is on its way for you. This also means that there is an opportunity for a new beginning headed your way. It could be something that requires you to be more creative or step outside of your comfort zone. But whatever this is, you are very excited about it. Moving into March, you get the Tower. With that Tower in March, I feel like this is you having to let go of something or something changing due to this new opportunity that is coming in for you in February. I do get the sense that this is a relationship for some, but not for all. Some, I feel like this is a sort of, some sort of like creative project or job. For others, I do feel like this is a relationship that is starting out. Whether it's a relationship, it's a new project, it's a new job, things in your world are going to start changing due to this new opportunity. Due to the fact that the Tower is in the upright position, I feel like this is you letting go on your own opportunities in stepping into this new time rather than being forced by the universe to let go of something. Relationships and personal matters. The next card you get is the Five of Wands. In May, it seems like there's some kind of competition going on. The fact that it is a wand, I do feel like it's dealing with a job or project, possibly trying to get a promotion, trying to be seen and get ahead of the pack, to step up into some sort of leadership. This is a relationship you've been trying to manifest. This could be feeling like you're in competition with someone else for this relationship. Into June, it looks like that's what you're focused on, is what you don't have, rather than what you have. As you can see on that Five of Cups, he's mourning over the three spilled cups, and not focusing on the two cups that are full and are right there. In June, try to find rest, try to find balance, things that make you happy. Focus on things that make you happy. If this is an actual loss, mourn your loss, feel that, and move forward. Don't hold on to this in old grudges or beat yourself up about it. You get is the Emperor. And in July, this is you stepping back into your own power, remembering who you are, felt what you had to feel, you've healed from it, you've learned from it, and now you're ready to move forward, feeling inspired and ready to conquer once again. August, you have the Four of Swords. This is a time of you stepping back, relaxing, being comfortable, action if need be, as you can see how he keeps one sword close to you. But this is a time of you stepping away from all the noise in the world and getting your mind right. The next card you get is the Queen of Cups. You are very inspired. You're open to new opportunities. Very emotionally balanced. You're gonna spend the summer getting back to you, back into your personal power, feeling that balance, that relaxed state of being. And you're gonna come out of the summer feeling 1,000 times better, more centered, and more peaceful. Moving into October, you get the Ace of Pentacles, and this is an opportunity for more money or material gains. This could be the raise you've been looking for in a job. This could be a promotion that comes with a raise. This could be you getting an apartment, a house, gaining something material that you've been trying to manifest. I do feel like it's a raise or some sort of promotion that you've been working to manifest, and it looks like in October it's finally making its way to you. Moving into November, you have the Page of Cups. I feel like that Page of Cups with that Ace of Pentacles that you got, this is you moving in, and you almost feel like a novice at this. Take things slowly, building up your confidence. You are excited about this opportunity, and it's almost like you're afraid of messing it up, but take things slowly. Build your confidence, and just know that as you progress on this path, with the more you learn, the more hands-on that you get, you're going to level up. Don't stop being curious, don't stop learning, don't let that fear overtake you. Keep moving forward in this new exciting time. You're ending your year with the Hierophant. And just like I was saying, this is you learning, progressing, moving forward, climbing up the ladder of success, whatever that means for you. I do feel like it's a gain in money due to possibly a promotion or taking on a better job. But there is learning that is going with it. It is showing that this is new for you and you are a beginner at it. But it's a new, exciting time. It's something you've been trying to manifest. And towards the end of 2022, you are going to step in it and harness that power and that confidence. You're going to learn a lot of new things. And it is a very happy, exciting time for you. Next, I'm gonna pull some oracle cards. first card you get is baby steps. And with this one, the oracle overall is telling you to keep moving forward. Don't stop. Don't let your feet become encased in concrete. Keep moving forward. Keep learning and trying to manifest what it is that you need. Whether it's more money that will come with a promotion, or maybe you need a car, or you're trying to get a new house. Keep moving forward and taking the logical steps you need to make sure that you are building the foundation that will lead to your portal. That way you can step in and manifest what it is that you're looking for. Use your intuition to help you get where you're trying to go. If you feel like the universe is telling you, I need to move departments at my job because I don't feel like I'm being seen where I'm at, then listen to that. If the universe is telling you to go a different way to work, then go a different way to work. Whatever it is that is calling out to you right now, follow it. And never stop moving. The next card you get is deep cellular healing. And in the year 2022, Libra, I feel like there is a lot of things that you are going to be healing from, especially early on in the year. I get the sense that towards the end of 2021, things have kind of gotten heavy. Maybe things didn't work out quite as well or in the way that you thought they would in 2022. Is going to be about you redirecting and steering down a new path, whether that's in relationships, career, projects, whatever the case may be. I see you healing not only mentally, emotionally, but physically. 2022 is going to help you feel more whole and centered once again. The next card you get is I'm sorry. This is about righting past wrongs. Like I was just saying, this is you redirecting some of this energy and finding your balance and feeling whole once again. You're going to be repairing relationships. You're going to be repairing how you feel on the inside. And remember to be gentle with yourself during this time of healing, especially when it comes to overthinking and self-criticizing. You are your own worst critic. Next, I'm gonna pull some moon oracle cards. Thank you. first card you get is full moon in Scorpio. It's time to release negativity. And as I was saying, with you finding that emotional balance and getting centered once again, all this negativity that's been weighing on you, things that have not been going your way in 2021, things are gonna start redirecting, balancing out, and it all starts with you and your mindset. Take a vacation. Try to put a positive spin on things that don't work out the way you want them to. Whatever it is that you need to do to help you release negativity, that's what you should do. As you saw with the Four of Swords that came up in the tarot, it's asking you to take a step back, relax, become balanced, remember who you are, and move forward in your power. The next card you get is Waxing Crescent Moon. Have faith in your dreams. There is something that you are trying to manifest early on in 2022, possibly towards the end of 2021, and it seems like you're having difficulties manifesting it. You almost feel all over the page here. So it's telling you to get back in balance. Have faith in your dreams and your abilities to manifest your desires. It does look like you need to find that balance and release any sort of negativity, negative thought patterns, negative people in your life, any sort of toxic situations, and get back to the purest form of yourself. Only then will you be able to move forward and manifest what it is that you desire. Next, I'm gonna bullet rune for any last bit of advice. Scorpio, possibly a child, a mother, a father, someone in your immediate family, I feel like, and there may have possibly been some sort of bad blood, and I get the sense this is who you're wanting to repair a relationship with. That may not resonate for everyone. Maybe only one of you. But I get the sense that that's what's going on. You're trying to repair a relationship with a Scorpio. But generally, this is about getting back to your roots, to your getting in touch with your spirit guides and feeling at one. Thank you for sitting with me through this reading. If you like this style reading or this reading resonated with you, please consider subscribing, liking, commenting down below. Feel free to share this video. Thank you and have a beautiful day.